Good morning. Thank you for joining us for ISS Update from the International Space Station Flight Control Room at the Johnson Space Center in Houston, Texas. On orbit, we have a new vehicle docked to the station. The ISS Progress 50 cargo ship automatically docked to the pier's docking compartment yesterday at 2:35 p.m. Central Time over the Caribbean Sea, completing a flawless, accelerated six-hour trek from the launch pad at the Baikonur Cosmodrome to the International Space Station. The hatch to the newly arrived Progress 50 was opened shortly after 6 a.m. Central Time this morning, allowing the crew to begin unloading the 2.9 tons of cargo, including air, oxygen, propellant, water and maintenance equipment, and experiment hardware. On board, the Expedition 34 crew of NASA astronaut and commander Kevin Ford, fellow astronaut Tom Marshburn, Canadian astronaut Chris Hadfield, and Russian cosmonauts Oleg Novitsky, Roman Romanenko, and Evgeny Tarelkin are in the early afternoon of their crew day. They woke up just after 2 a.m. Central Time, again a slightly adjusted schedule in support of the Progress activities, and had some personal time for hygiene and breakfast before their daily planning conference, a tag-up with all of the supporting control centers around the globe that support the International Space Station operations. Immediately after wake-up, Commander Kevin Ford spoke with students from the United Kingdom via ham radio. The students were at Breadalbane Academy. Using the ham radio, Kevin spoke with the students about life in space and other space-related topics. The rest of his morning and some of the afternoon has been focused on a lengthy task supporting maintenance for the internal thermal control system that's scheduled for about 5 hours of his crew day. Again, all of that going smoothly this morning and continuing into the afternoon. He'll be joining fellow astronaut Tom Marshburn for questions from reporters later in the morning. Tom Marshburn also included exercise sessions on his morning, including work on the advanced resistive exercise device and then on the treadmill. He also had time dedicated to pre-packing for the Dragon cargo vehicle, which is expected to arrive at the space station in early March. Tom Marshburn also worked about an hour on the Human Research Facility Pulmonary Function Gas Management System, calibrating that equipment. The Pulmonary Function System is a collaborative effort between NASA and the European Space Agency to develop a system for pulmonary physiology monitoring on the International Space Station. Again, that work today included about one hour of work to calibrate some of the equipment supporting that experiment. He also worked on some routine maintenance on the treadmill on board, as well as installation of a video camera assembly in the Columbus module, which is designed to accommodate high-definition capability later this year. Tom's morning also included work on the journal experiment, which is an ongoing experiment throughout several increments, where they study behavioral issues associated with the isolation and confinement experienced during long-duration missions. Review and analysis of astronaut journals obtains information on behavioral and human issues that are relevant to the equipment and procedures and sustained human performance during extended duration missions. Study results will help provide information to help prepare for future missions to low Earth orbit and beyond. Meanwhile, their counterpart, Chris Hadfield, worked on a variety of science experiments. He worked on configurations on an Express experiment rack, and also worked on the binary colloid alloy test, which studies nanoscale particles in fluid commonly found in paints, polishing compounds, and food products that will help with researchers studying that material science. He also worked on experiment hardware and configurations, including work on the material science laboratory, where he replaced some of the sample cartridges, installed software on a European Space Agency payload laptop, and also conducted a locker swap with the vehicle cabin assembly. Their fellow cosmonauts were focused on Progress activities, including a leak check, the ingress, and the start of the unloading of the near 3 tons of supplies and equipment that arrived in the Progress. That unpacking will continue throughout most of the week.